Welcome, everybody. We are gearing up for tonight's action. Patrice Bergeron in the perfection line. 10 points combined last game. Series is tied at 2. Charlie McAvoy cleared NHL protocols wearing the mask. He was out last game due to COVID. Meanwhile, the Carolina Hurricanes looking to continue the trend of every team this series winning at home. Stahl and company arriving to the arena. We have a very busy night on ESPN and ESPN2, beginning with that Bruins-Carolina Hurricanes Game 7 Eastern on ESPN. Here in studio with Chris Chelios, PK Subban, a couple of Montreal Canadiens draft picks, I'm Ardo Cal. Before we get to the draft lottery, though, what game are you looking forward to most tonight and why?
Tampa Bay, Toronto, defending Stanley Cup champions, the Nova Scotia Arena is going to be on fire. A lot of pressure on Toronto.
Carolina-Boston, I think PNC Arena is going to be out of this world loud. I think the energy is going to be great, and it's going to be a full 60-minute tilt.
All right, before we get to those games, it's the NHL Draft Lottery with Jamie Hirsch and Kevin Weeks, 40th overall, 43rd, by the way. I think they had some pretty good careers. We'll be back all night. Over to Jamie and Kevin.
When attempting to build a champion, a franchise needs a few ingredients. You'll need your stars.
Here it is! Stars! There's a new member of the 60-goal club!
A goalie who you can rely on.
Step by Vasilevsky!
Rock-solid defenseman.
Hodge fakes! Scores! Rangers win!
But who are we kidding? You also need some luck.
Look at the wide stance, and then, of course, you get lucky.
That brings us to tonight, where a little bit of that luck could set your team on the path to greatness.
The winner of the draft lottery is the Colorado Avalanche. The first overall pick belongs to the Edmonton Oilers.
The first overall selection in the New Jersey Devils.
Welcome to the 2022 NHL Draft Lottery. The lottery ball machine has been fired up and we'll soon know if Montreal will retain the top pick or if another team will overtake the Canadiens and own the rights to select from a number of elite prospects. Those prize prospects include Logan Cooley, who was named the top forward at the 2022 Under-18 World Championships. The 6'4", 225-pound Slovakian forward, Yaroslav Kovský, who scored 7 goals at the Olympic Games. And Shane Wright, who has long been considered the top prospect in this draft. Wright was the 2018-19 OHL Rookie of the Year, and he's now the captain of the Kingston Frontenacs in the OHL playoffs. The 16 general managers participating in the draft lottery are with us remotely and will soon learn the fate of their draft position for the first round of the 2022 Upper Deck NHL Draft on July 7th in Montreal. Hello, everyone, and welcome inside NHL Network Studios for the 2022 NHL Draft Lottery. I'm Jamie Hirsch alongside Kevin Weeks. We are so excited to be here with you to unveil the order of the first 16 picks, which will start to put things in place for the upcoming draft. Weeksy, how much anticipation and excitement is there tonight on both the parts of the prospects and the teams themselves?
Yeah, for the prospects, they're pumped at what the future could potentially hold, the way this draft lottery may shape out. And, of course, for the teams, a glimpse of that exactly, how their future can be shaped by some of these young prospects that are about to be drafted. So exciting, especially for our great NHL fans.
Yeah, we can't wait. But before we get started, there are some rule changes to this year's draft lottery. So let's take a look. A team will only be able to move up a maximum of 10 spots if they win one of the two lottery draws. So with 16 teams in the lottery, only teams positioned from 1 through 11 in the pre-draft lottery order could actually claim the first overall pick. If a team positioned from 12 to 16 wins the draft lottery, that means Montreal would be locked in at number one. Another change beginning this year is that teams cannot win the lottery more than twice in a 5-year period. Here's a look at the current draft order prior to tonight's lottery, and we do have some conditions to consider. Chicago currently has the 6th pick, which it will transfer to Columbus as part of the Seth Jones trade. However, if that pick becomes a top 2 pick as a result of the draft lottery, Chicago will retain the pick and instead transfer to Columbus its first round pick in the 2023 NHL draft.
The other condition comes with Vegas at 16 per the trade for Jack Eichel. The Golden Knights will transfer their first round pick in this year's NHL draft to Buffalo if it is not a top 10 pick. So if Vegas comes up in either the first or second lottery draw, they will retain the pick and instead transfer to Buffalo their first round pick in 2023.
Now, something very rare could be set in motion tonight. With Montreal hosting the 2022 Upper Deck NHL Draft and currently holding the best odds to win the number one pick, it could be the first time since 1985 that the host city's team selects first overall. The Maple Leafs selected Wendell Clark in that draft, and he went on to play parts of 13 seasons in Toronto, three as captain. It's time to introduce our team representatives, and we'll begin in Montreal with GM Kent Hughes. It could be the first time Montreal has the first selection since 1980. Representing the Coyotes, GM Bill Armstrong, who is overseeing his second draft. And Seattle General Manager Ron Francis. The Kraken moved up to number two in last year's draft lottery, selecting Matty Beniers.
Representing the Philadelphia Flyers, GM Chuck Fletcher. Philadelphia did not have a first-round pick in last year's draft. From New Jersey, GM Tom Fitzgerald. The Devils added a second Hughes to their roster, selecting Luke last year at number four. And in Chicago for the Blackhawks, General Manager Kyle Davidson. Chicago will find out if they'll end up with a top two pick or if their selection is going to Columbus.
And representing Ottawa, GM Pierre Dorion. The Senators selected Tyler Boucher at number 10 last year. For Detroit, General Manager Steve Yzerman is overseeing his fourth draft with the Red Wings. And from Buffalo, GM Kevin Adams, who selected Owen Power last year with the first overall pick.
Representing Anaheim, newly appointed General Manager of the Ducks, Pat Verbeek. For San Jose, interim GM of the Sharks, Joe Will, who stepped in for Doug Wilson back in November. And from Columbus, General Manager Jarmo Kekalainen. The Blue Jackets could end up with two picks in the first round this year.
Representing the New York Islanders, GM Lou Lamoriello, who has overseen NHL drafts for 3.5 decades. And from Winnipeg, Jets General Manager Kevin Cheveldayoff, who is overseeing his 11th draft with the club. For Vancouver, it's GM Patrick Alvin. He joined the Canucks in January and is the second European to be named a general manager in the NHL. And representing Vegas, one of the original Golden Knights, Derek Englund. This is the first draft lottery for Vegas since the Golden Knights joined the league for the 2017-18 season. So here's an aggregate list of the top 10 prospects, and at the top, where he's been for a while, is Shane Wright, the consensus top prospect and expected first overall pick. Shane Wright was selected first overall in 2019 by Kingston, and he did not disappoint, winning the Rookie of the Year award in 2019-20. The OHL was shut down due to COVID in 2020-21, but this past season, Shane Wright delivered a stellar performance with 94 points in 63 games. And we are so pleased to welcome in Shane Wright now. Shane, how would you describe what you're feeling knowing that very soon you'll find out where your NHL career will most likely begin?
That's a pretty crazy feeling. Obviously, you know, with the lottery coming up tonight, it's you know, gonna be a big night. Obviously, you know, I'm playing a game, so I won't know you know, what the order is until after the game. But obviously, it's pretty exciting, and you know, looking forward to it.
Shane, I spoke to a few people close to you. I understand you come from a family of soccer players, and you love soccer. You played yourself, but you are the elite prospect in this draft. And I've been told that you are a very complete player. I think the same in watching your game. How would you describe your game?
Yeah, I would say I'm a really strong two-foot player. I think I'm a lead offensive player that can also, you know, take care of his own end and play really strong, you know, in all aspects of the game. I think I'm a smart player who thinks the game at a high level and can also score and make plays. But I also, you know, really take care of my own end and really play strong defensively. So I think I can, you know, do a lot of things right.
You're making sweet music on the ice, but I understand you're working on learning how to make sweet music off the ice. Tell us about the guitar. How's that going so far?
Yeah, about a month and a half, 2 months ago, recently just bought my own acoustic guitar. A couple of my teammates on my team, you know, they have one as well. So, you know, I figured, you know, might as well try and buy one and, you know, see how it goes. And it's been a lot of fun. It's a little difficult at times, but, you know, I love it, and it's a lot of fun.
Well, good luck with your game tonight, and get ready for that phone to be blown up when you get off the ice. You're going to have all kinds of text messages and voicemails from your friends and family. Congrats on the success so far, and good luck going forward.
Yeah, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Okay, Scott Clark from Ernst & Young is on his way into the studio, which means the results are in. We'll start to reveal the draft order with Bill Daly after this.
The winner of the 2021 draft lottery is the Buffalo Sabres.
Welcome to the 2021 NHL Draft. Buffalo, you're on the clock.
On behalf of the Buffalo Sabres and all of our great fans, we are proud to select from the University of Michigan, Owen Power.
Not a surprise, 6'6" tall. You can see the height right there. Great head of hair.
Tonight is the night he's dreamt of his NHL debut.
Tried to cut inside, following up. Power slides one and shoots and scores! There it is! Owen Power's first in the NHL, and it's a beauty!
Welcome back to the 2022 NHL Draft Lottery Show. Earlier tonight, Commissioner Gary Bettman oversaw the draw, and here's Scott Clark of Ernst & Young to deliver the results of the draft lottery to Deputy Commissioner Bill Daly, which means we are moments away from revealing the draft order. Thank you, Scott. And Bill, nice to see you. Thanks so much for being here.
Nice to see you guys.
Great to see you.
So this year, the draft lottery is a bit earlier than in years past. Why?
Well, I think our GMs by nature are very, very competitive, and I think they want as much time as they can to prepare with their scouts for the draft, particularly when you're talking about very high picks.
And what's the league hoping to accomplish with some of these rule changes?
Well, I think the reduction in the number of draws and then the limitation on move-ups were both meant to reduce the number of low-finishing clubs that fall dramatically in the draft and to impact the magnitude of that fall.
Okay, without further ado, let's find out the results of this year's NHL Draft Lottery. Bill, the floor is yours.
I wish all 16 clubs participating in the draft lottery good luck, and let's get this underway. The 16th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Vegas Golden Knights.
And this pick will actually transfer to the Buffalo Sabres as part of the Golden Knights trade for Jack Eichel this year. Buffalo has drafted 16th overall four previous times, and the last time was in 2013 when they selected Nikita Zadorov.
The 15th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Vancouver Canucks.
This is the first time that the Vancouver Canucks have had the 15th overall pick. This will be GM Patrick Alvin's first draft since taking over as the general manager of the Canucks.
The 14th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Winnipeg Jets.
This is the first time the Jets will select with the 14th pick. Last year, they drafted Chaz Lucius with the 18th overall pick.
The 13th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the New York Islanders.
This is the first time since 2019 that the Islanders will have a first-round draft pick. The last time they drafted 13th overall was back in 1987, selecting Dean Chenelf.
The 12th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Columbus Blue Jackets.
The Blue Jackets also had the 12th pick in last year's draft, selecting forward Cole Sillinger, who went on to have a great rookie season this year.
The 11th overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the San Jose Sharks.
And this is the first time since 1994 that the Sharks will select with the 11th overall pick, when they selected Jeff Friesen.
The number 10 pick in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Anaheim Ducks.
The Ducks have made five first-round selections over the last 3 years, including Trevor Zegras, who was drafted ninth overall in 2019. This will be Pat Verbeek's first NHL Draft as GM of the Ducks.
The number 9 overall pick in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Buffalo Sabres.
The Sabres will have multiple picks once again, selecting at both 9th and 16th overall. This will be the third time in the last 4 years that Buffalo's had multiple first-round picks.
The number 8 overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Detroit Red Wings.
This is only the second time Detroit has had the 8th overall pick. The last time was back in 1985. And so far, things are going as planned in terms of the pre-draft order odds.
The number 7 overall pick in the 2022 NHL draft belongs to the Ottawa Senators.
This will mark the first time the Senators have drafted 7th overall. They selected Tyler Boucher with the 10th overall pick in last year's draft.
The number 6 overall selection in the 2022 NHL draft belongs to the Chicago Blackhawks.
The Blackhawks will actually transfer this pick to the Columbus Blue Jackets as part of the trade for Seth Jones. This is the second straight year the Jackets will have multiple first-round picks after they had 3 last year.
The number 5 overall selection in the 2022 NHL draft belongs to the Philadelphia Flyers.
The Flyers will select the 5th overall pick for the first time since their inaugural season way back in 1967. That means the New Jersey Devils will have either the number 1 or number 2 pick in this year's draft.
The number 4 overall pick in the 2022 NHL draft belongs to the Seattle Kraken.
This is only the 2nd draft the Kraken will take part in after Seattle drafted Matty Beniers 2nd overall in their inaugural season. That brings us to the top 3 spots, which means there are 3 GMs anxiously awaiting to hear their team's name called as the winner of this year's NHL Draft Lottery. Montreal, Arizona, or New Jersey? Find out next. After the draft, stay tuned. After the draft lottery, stay tuned for some playoff hockey with the Bruins and Hurricanes Game 5 on ESPN and Sportsnet. This series tied at 2 apiece. We are down to the final 3 teams waiting to see if they will own the rights to this year's top overall pick. We have Montreal, Arizona, and New Jersey. Bill, take it away.
I wish each of you guys a lot of luck. The number 3 overall selection in the 2022 NHL draft belongs to the Arizona Coyotes.
This is familiar territory for the Coyotes, who selected Dylan Strome 3rd overall in 2015 and Kyle Turris with the number 3 pick back in 2007. So now we know either the Montreal Canadiens or New Jersey Devils will own the rights to select 1st overall in the 2022 Upper Deck NHL Draft. Bill?
The 1st overall selection in the 2022 NHL Draft belongs to the Montreal Canadiens. Means number 2, the New Jersey Devils.
Congratulations to the Canadiens. For the 2nd straight year, the team with the best odds will retain the top selection as the Montreal Canadiens win the 2022 draft lottery. This will be the 6th time in franchise history the Habs will pick first, and the first time since 1980 when they took Doug Wickenheiser 1st overall. We see a lot of excitement, no doubt, in Montreal. Take a look at some history here for the Habs. We mentioned it's the first time in 42 years that the Habs have been able to select 1st overall, but just especially with the fact that Montreal is going to be hosting this year's NHL draft, and now they get to select 1st overall. It's the first time that this has happened since all the way back in 1985. Wendell Clark taken in Toronto back then with the 1st overall pick. So congratulations to Kent Hughes. Thanks so much for joining us here. What does this mean both to the city of Montreal and the fan base and your club too, to not only host the draft, to be able to select 1st overall?
I think it's obviously a very exciting outcome for us. Our fans, I'm sure, will be thrilled, especially with the draft being held in Montreal, to have that kind of anticipation and excitement leading into it. So we're excited. I think it's a great opportunity for our organization to start taking strides towards returning to the playoffs here.
Kent, félicitations à vous. Congratulations to you and the fans there. Maybe tell us one identifying trait that you're looking for as you build this team going forward.
Well, I think if it's anything, it's character. We've talked a lot about the culture that we need, and you don't have that type of culture as a team if you don't have character in your players.
Well, Kent, congrats on winning the 1st overall pick in this year's draft lottery. We'll see you at the draft in July.
Thank you, guys.
Exciting times. The Habs, of course, less than a year ago in the Stanley Cup Final. Now here they are hosting the draft. Brought to you by Upper Deck. Round one starts July 7th. You can see where you can find that draft. And then, of course, rounds 2 through 7 the next day on July 8th. It's an exciting time to be a Habs fan week.
Absolutely. They're pumped right now. Devils fan just up the road, pumped as well here in Jersey.
Yes, this will be the third time in the last 6 years the New Jersey Devils will either select first or second overall. They're fully rebuilding, and the future is bright. Thanks so much for joining us. Enjoy the night around the Stanley Cup playoffs, and we'll see you next time.
Charlie McAvoy is expected to play. He cleared COVID-19 protocol after missing game 4. He has 2 assists in 3 games in this series. Back with our Montreal Canadian draft picks after the break.